Everybody, welcome to WhyBuy. Today we're going to be talking about the DJI Mini 2.
We're going to go for a quick rip. First time I saw drone footage and I saw someone piloting a drone, I was like, okay, how do I get one? What do I need to operate this thing? Can I just go out and fly it? There's a lot of laws in place that prevent you from, you know, just going and buying a drone and flying it through your neighbor's yard. But what's interesting about the Mini 2 is that it's an ultralight design that's under the 250 gram weight classification, which in a lot of regions, it's considered a toy. So why do you want a drone? It's okay to just buy this drone and use it as a hobby to get some great imagery. They're so cheap and they're so compact to take with you anywhere, especially if you travel or if you do a lot of outdoor activities, the cool gadget to have with you. But you might need it for work. You might be a videographer and you're looking to get some interesting shots and it might help your production. But since you're watching this video, I just wanted to point out some of the things that really kind of helped me decide that this was going to be the drone that I was going to buy. So when you start to unbox and you look at the quality of the materials and you know what you get with the drone, like with other DJI products, you'll notice that it's fairly good value. You're getting good bang for the buck. The materials feel good, albeit plastic. You know, it doesn't feel chintzy. The build quality is superb, especially for the money, for what you're paying for. It's a phenomenal product. And you'll notice that in the quality, just in the controller, the bag even that comes with the Flymore combo is it's a nice material. It's a nice camera bag to take around with you. So on a single full charge in flight time, you're looking at about 30 minutes. Now that's gonna depend on how you film. So it actually has three modes for filming. One is cinema or cine, the other one's normal, and the other one is sport. Basically, it's the speed at which your input affects the drone speed. So obviously, if you're zipping around in sport mode, or it's having to fight a lot of wind, you're gonna cook through the battery faster. Temperature affects that too, but that's one thing I should point out. So the operating temperature is 0 degrees Celsius to, you know, 40 degrees Celsius. I actually took it out in minus 30 degrees Celsius and flew it around and it kept up. I was really impressed with the fact that, you know, the flight time was less. You're probably looking at only, I would say half, you know, maybe 10 minutes on a single charge of the battery, but for it to zip around in minus 30, like, I didn't want to stand out there for more than 10 minutes. So that thing is awesome. But there's two ways it stores your photos and videos. It can store directly onto the micrSD card you have fixed in the drone, and it can also store onto your phone, kind of doubling up in case you lose the drone and can't retrieve it. You know, you have at least the footage on your phone, but I turn that off. I just have it, I take my chances and leave it stored on the card. When you're looking at a micrSD card though, make sure, because of the transfer rate, the bit rate speed, you're gonna want to see or look for that symbol. It's like a U with a 3 in it. If you don't get a fast enough memory card, what you'll find is your write speed is too slow. So you get like this jittery image, or the quality can be dumbed down, and just buy the right memory card. So that's that symbol, U3. The camera that's fixed onto the front gimbal, well, I guess it's the only camera, is the, it's a 12 megapixel camera, and it actually has a really good image stabilization built into the camera, but also with the gimbal, even in high winds or kind of jerking around with speed, you'll find that the image quality is fantastic. It stays locked and it just is smooth. And I even took it out on a windy day, flew it up to get some shots of the city. And, you know, from my perspective, this thing's like shaking all over the place. I'm like, oh man, it's gonna look like crap. And no, I looked at the footage finally and you're seeing it now, like it's smooth. This is with no post, you know, image stabilization. That's all the camera work in the drone and in the software for the app. One thing I really like is that there's a tilt function as well. So you can actually, there's a piece of the controller, and I'll, you know, there's a part of the controller, it's like a scroll wheel, and you can just, that helps, you know, kind of tilt the camera down. So if you want to point it, you know, directly vertical and fly the drone straight up, some pretty cool shots you can get, and it's fairly quick to respond. You know, it feels satisfying in your hands. It's just, again, that build quality. One thing, when I read it, I had to kind of like look twice. I'm like, that can't be right. But this thing can fly up to 3 kilometers through like broken line of sight. And supposedly, with a clear line of sight, like in a field, it can fly up to 10 kilometers. Now, for one, wow, that's crazy. And two, I don't think I'll ever let it out of my sight. Technically speaking, if you are flying this thing around, you should always keep line of sight just for safety reasons. So in terms of the camera and the quality of that it can film at, so if you're filming in 4K, you can film at 24 frames a second, which is pretty good for most, you know, cinema quality. That's what you want to be shooting at anyways. But say you're doing like slow motion stuff in post and you want to shoot at like 60 frames a second, it can't do 4K, but it will shoot full HD at 1080. At 60 frames a second. So a bit of a compromise there, but again, this is a beginner drone. You know, this isn't, you know, that top tier where you're gonna be getting that, you know, incredible footage. For the price and the value, take it for what it is. One thing I didn't think I would use, but it really does come in handy, are the quick shot modes. So the quick shot modes are built into the app, and it basically, it's like a hands-free filming experience where, so I got my subject here, which is us, okay, me, and I could move too, it'll track me, but I'm just going to start a helix motion, and if you watch, I mean, it's, I guess I'm recording on here too, but again, I'm not touching the controls, but it's kind of just doing its thing. The only drawback, and I haven't figured out how to change it, maybe there's a way, but by default, it shoots those at 1080, not 4K, so pretty sure there's a way to fix that, I'll have to double check, but either way, the footage looks cool. So, for example, if you're like an influencer or a YouTuber, you just set this thing to track you and, you know, put your controls down somewhere and it'll just go do its thing. That's pretty cool. Oh, and it almost went into a tree.
Oh boy.
So that's a good example. You need to be in an open space with this guy because it doesn't have side or rear sensors. Because this drone doesn't have sensors on the side or any of the sides, if you set to one of these automatic, you know, features where it's doing a circle or a helix, essentially what you're running the risk of is if you don't see where it's going, you could fly it into a tree, you could fly it into a building and destroy it. So you have to be careful when using these kind of unique, cool features. And because we're surrounded by trees, yeah, I almost accidentally flew it into a tree just now. So eyes open.
If you buy just the drone, you only get one battery. And I'm telling you, you're going to want a spare or at least two. And in the Fly More combo, you get two spare batteries. And the benefit also is that you get a charger. You also get spare propellers. Now, thankfully, I haven't destroyed them yet. Another thing too, haven't made use of them, but good to have because I don't know where you would get them, are spare screws. And you actually have a tool that has a fine enough screw head to replace any screws if, you know, anything gets loose or lost and that sort of thing. With just the buying the drone, you don't actually get the USB fast charger. You're gonna wanna have that with these batteries. Again, that Fly More combo, just buy it. You're gonna be mad at yourself if you don't. My favorite thing about the drone is just the fact that it's accessible. And what I mean by that is it's cheap. It shoots beautiful footage. The controls are very intuitive. Now, I will say, if you've never flown a drone before, or you've like never played video games or flight simulators, it might feel weird at first, but you'll pick it up fairly quickly. And really, I think it's just one of those cameras, you couldn't replace it with, say, like an iPhone that had a, you know, a great camera that just got released. You're not gonna chuck it up in the air and try and get those aerial shots. It's one of those tools that's great to have, and you'll probably use it for, you know, a long time. And I think you'll hear that a lot around the internet about how this drone is like, ooh, wow, it's quite impressive. It's good enough.
I'm not saying it's just good enough. I'm saying this thing is awesome. Like, you have to think how far drone technology has come and where we're at now. Sure, there are incredibly impressive cinematic drones that you can buy for $300,000, but I'm saying that not too long ago, something like this was in that realm. You're looking at 4K image quality with a terrific image stabilization, controls that you only need a single pilot to operate the camera and the drone at, you know, simultaneously. This is a really cool product, like in terms of gadgets and cameras, and it's just I think people downplay it because there's just so many options now that DJI has spoiled us with. But really, in terms of a new product, a new drone, I think they knocked it out of the park. I think this is by far the best, most accessible drone that DJI makes.
So if you thought this video was helpful, please show your support, like and subscribe, and thanks for watching. The wind's always so bad here. Okay, I won't do the coolest gadget you can get it today. I'm gonna try one more time. Is that bad? Is that
so bad?
Let's talk about the DJI.
Yeah. Because it's on camera.
Are we cool?
We're cool. And it's cool.
It's cool.
It's so cool.
It's pretty cool.
This is too many cools. No. Now it's just getting warm.